In this video, you'll see how to do a basic, an advanced, and an expert search for bibliographic records in WorldCat through WorldShare Acquisitions. We'll also take a brief look at searching WorldCat indexes, which can help to determine which indexes to use for the specific data you want to search, and can also help you determine which mark fields and subfields are included in the available indexes. In WorldShare Acquisitions, you'll need to search for a bibliographic record to find a record for ordering, to find a record to add holdings for a gift or an item you have in a backlog or that was not acquired in the WMS acquisitions ordering process. You may also want to search for a record to add a second copy or to delete holdings for an item you no longer have. First, let's take a look at the user preferences for searching WorldCat in acquisitions. You can set preferences for which search scopes display for use. In acquisitions, the scopes are All WorldCat and My Library Holdings, which is the WorldCat database scoped to just the records that have your library's holdings. You can also set the default sorting order, and you can set which indexes display for use in each scope and the order of the display. So let's look at this in WMS Acquisitions. After logging into WMS and selecting Acquisitions, I'll click Discover Items. And then, below the basic search area, I'll click User Preferences. Then I'll click Searching Basic to review the basic search user preferences. Here, you can select the search scopes that you want to display by clicking the checkbox in the Display column. I have both All WorldCat and My Library Holdings checked to display, and I think most libraries would want both to display for use. Then I can click on a search scope. I'll click All WorldCat, and here I can specify which indexes I want to display and in what order they should be listed. Currently, title is displayed first, but I can use the up and down arrows to change the order of display. For example, I'll move author up by clicking the up arrow. Notice when I make a change, an orange dot appears on the Bibliographic Records tab and on the User Preferences button on the left to remind me I have unsaved changes. I can also change the default sorting order for search results currently set to relevance by clicking the drop-down and selecting another sort option, but I'll leave it set at relevance. Remember, you can always change the sort when you do a search. And I'll close the basic search preferences now by clicking the arrow again. And I'll click Searching Advanced to see the preferences for advanced searching. For the advanced search, you have the option to set a default language of cataloging, and I have mine set to English. There's also an option to set DLC, Library of Congress, as a default source of cataloging, but I've left mine set at Any. You can always change this search by search if you want. Then there are the same search scopes for bibliographic records available for the advanced search, All WorldCat and My Library Holdings. And if I click, for example, the All WorldCat scope, I can see the available indexes. Like the basic search, you can set the indexes you want to display for use and the order they display and the default sort method. And if I scroll down, you'll see there are many more indexes available for the advanced search. You can also use the up and down arrows to set the display order. I'll scroll back up now, and I'll click Save to save the changes that I made. And the system confirms saved the preferences. Now you can see that author index for the basic search appears at the top of my list of indexes since I made that change in the user preferences. Now I'm going to do a basic search and an advanced search, and I'll finally show you how to do an expert search. So let's say I have a copy of Great Circle by Maggie Shipstead. And since I have an ISBN, I know I can usually use this and do just a basic search. If you have a number such as an ISBN, it's always best to start with that because your results will be more precise. After logging into WMS, I'll select Acquisitions. So first we'll look at the basic searching, so I'll select Discover Items. Next, I have the option to select all of WorldCat for my search scope, or I can select My Library's Holdings to search for records in WorldCat which already have my holdings. If I've not previously added any copies or holdings for a title, I'll want to make sure I'm searching All WorldCat. Next, I'll click the Indexes dropdown, and I'll select the ISBN index. And then I'll enter the ISBN in the search box, and then I'll click Search, or you could just hit Enter on your keyboard. My search results in four records. If you have a record manager cataloging role, You could see the full bibliographic record by clicking View Edit Metadata to see it in Record Manager. Or I can hover over the blue eye and I can see some additional bibliographic information on the window that pops up. I have another example of a title that I want to order, Isabel Allende's A Long Petal of the Sea, but let's say I don't have an ISBN. So I'll leave the scope set to All WorldCat, and I'll click the index dropdown, and I'll select the keyword index, and I'll clear the search box, and I'll enter the author's name and words from the title, Long Petal, and you can see the search box expands as I'm entering terms, and then I'll click search. My search results in 71 records. I'll use the facets to refine my search. So I'll click English as the language of cataloging, and now I have 55 records. I'll also select the format print book, and now I have 18 records. I'll scroll down so I can see the rest of the facets. I'll also check English as the language of the resource, and now I have just 14 records. Finally, I have a publication date of 2020, so I'll also select that in the date facet. And now I have just 8 records, and I can see that the third record in my results is a DLC Library Congress record. Now let's look at the advanced search. The advanced search allows you to search in up to 5 indexes at a time, and you can use the Boolean operators and, or not. Also, you can use facets or limits to refine the search, but these are applied along with your search terms before you do the search. So let's say I'm looking for a record for this CD set, the Bach concertos, and I have the CDs and the case. So I have a title, a personal name author, Bach, and a corporate name author for the orchestra, the English concert, and I have a publisher and a date. So I'll click on Advanced Search, which you'll find right below the basic search area. I'll leave the scope set to All WorldCat, and I'll use the title index and enter words from the title. The title keyword index, indicated by the index label TI colon, is a keyword in that you don't have to enter all of the words, and they don't have to be in order from left to right, as a phrase search would be. And a phrase search is indicated by the index label followed by an equal sign. So I'll enter the title, concertos, harpsichord, violin, flute, oboe, dimmer. And then I'll use the personal name index, and I'll enter Bach. And I'll use the corporate name index, and I'll enter the name of the orchestra English concert. I also want to add the publisher, so I'll click the green circle to add an index. And for the publisher, I'll enter archive. Next, I'll click the drop down for formats, and I'll select the music CD format. Next, I'll click in the year text box, and I'll enter 1984. And then I'll click the source of cataloging dropdown, and I'll select DLC, which is the only option other than the default any. But if I get no search results, I would come back and take off the DLC as a limit. And finally, I'll click search. And my search retrieves just one record. The final search type I'll show you is called an expert search. You can do an expert search in the basic search text box or in the advanced search text box. It doesn't matter which index is selected because you'll be providing the index labels along with your search terms all on one line. While viewing the basic search area, if you click the question mark to the right of the search box, you'll see a window pop up with some help on performing an expert search. There's also a link to searching WorldCat indexes where you can find out what the index labels are and also which fields and subfields are indexed in a specific index. In addition, if you know the mark tag for the field you want to search, you can find out which indexes include that field. So again, using my example from the advanced search, I'll show you how to perform the same search as an expert search. So first, I'll enter the index label for the title keyword index, TI, followed by the words of the title, and then I'll enter the personal name index, PN colon, followed by the composer Bach. Since I want to use the Boolean operator AND, I don't have to include that as it's understood to be AND by default. However, if I wanted to use or not, I would need to type them out in all caps between the terms. Next, I'll enter the corporate name index label, CO colon, followed by the name of the orchestra, English concert. Then I'll enter the index label for publisher, P, pb colon and the publisher archive. And I'll enter the format, so the index label for that is mt colon and then cda for compact disc audio. And the year index label would be yr colon followed by the year 1984. And finally, I've entered the index label for source, which in an expert search is going to be CS equals, and then I've entered DLC for Library of Congress. And now I'll click on search. And it retrieves the same DLC record we saw in the advanced search. Finally, we'll take a quick look at searching WorldCat indexes. You saw the link to searching WorldCat indexes if you click the question mark in the basic search area. You can also go there directly by going to help.oclc.org and then select Librarian's Toolbox, where you'll also find other useful tools and documentation. So using the same example CD from before, let's say I notice there's a number, a UPC code on the back of the CD, and I want to find out how I can use it to search for this item. From the Searching WorldCat Indexes page, click on Bibliographic Record Indexes in the Bibliographic Records section. Since I don't know the index label or name, I would click Bibliographic Record Indexes by Data Type, since I'm looking for a number index. The indexes by data type include call number indexes, date indexes, and name indexes. And if I scroll down, I see the number indexes. Since I don't see the UPC number specifically here, I'm going to select the standard number index. This is a fairly broad index that includes several different types of number indexes. And a window pops up for the standard number index, and in fact, there is a description that states it includes the UPC number in addition to several other types of numbers. And there is a keyword index with the label SN colon and a phrase index with the label SN equals. I'll click the keyword standard number index, and I can see again the label is SN colon. And there is a search option with this index, but not a browse option, using WorldShare or Discovery. And if I scroll down, I can see some examples and also the marked tags and subfields that are included in this index. So I'll do a search using the UPC number on my item with the standard number index. I'll enter the index label SN colon followed by the number, and then I'll click search. And I've retrieved 7 records. I'll use the language of cataloging facet and I'll select English. And I have just 3 records now, including the DLC record that we found with the advanced search previously. If you have questions, you can find contact information for OCLC support in your region, as well as documentation and additional training at help.oclc.org.